Hey Saber fans, this is Adam from Blue Force Sabers. Welcome back. So this is a custom commission I just finished. So the design of the saber, the customer wanted a mixture of the Rebel symbol, as you can see up here, Mandalorian, and then the Galactic Empire symbol, which is in the pommel area. He also liked the design of my Batman saber. So I took that saber, redesigned it, incorporated the three symbols, and this is what I came out with. So with the Batman saber, if you're not familiar with it, it had this cool honeycomb effect within the design. So I changed it up, switched it around, and this is the design I came out with. So a couple of the details with it before I get into it and start it up. Crystal Focus 10 on the inside, 24 millimeter bass speaker. This has the single switch mod. And usually with the Crystal Focus, I usually do the dual switches with it, but he wanted a illuminated switch. So I decided to go with the single button mod, which works out really well with this because you have the recharge port here, 2.1 millimeter recharge port, custom red kill key. And then you have a removable chassis. It's all locked inside, but you have access to the SD card, battery, and all that too, if you want to. Or you can just charge it up by the recharge port here. So let's go over a couple of the details of the saber, starting at the emitter here. So I said with the Batman saber, it has this cool honeycomb effect. I went and incorporate the Rebel symbol into the top here. So you can see down here, this is the 1-inch steel core, and then the 3D print is wrapped around it. So the blade's going to slide in here, so you'll get this cool shine through when the blade's in there. And that wraps all the way around. As far as the paint goes, couple different layers of paint here. It's painted flat black, and then this has this silver paint over top. And then several layers of dry brushes on top of that. A bronze to give it more of a weather look, because he wanted a heavy weather look with this. Then it's a silver, and then there's a black wash to bring out all these details, again, these grooves and stuff like that, which the black wash really works great with this honeycomb. And all these different ridges and stuff like that, it really gets that dirt and that grime into there. So it really gives it a nice, cool weathered effect to it. And I hope it comes out on camera here, but I'm not sure. Is this cool bronze wash that's over top? You definitely see it in person. A little hard to come up, I guess, on camera here. But there is this bronze wash that goes over the top of the entire thing. It really gives it a different and unique look to it. But anyway, going into the switch area, you have this angle cut here so you can still see the chrome underneath. A couple little cutouts here too. Mandalorian symbol on the back. Painted red with a silver wash over top of that too. And you just have all these little divots and indentations here. You can't tell that's the Mandalorian's mask, his helmet. And then the switch and the recharge port mounted in the middle. Down to this nice brown leather wrap, authentic leather, super soft, really nice. Couple little extra details in the leather here too. Down to the pommel, so you have the separation with the pommel and the leather, so you see a little more of the chrome. And then this comes up as well. This is part of the Rebel symbol. Painted red just to give it a little more, just a different look. Also on the back side, more of the honeycomb, so it has a nice flow through the saber and matches up well. Down to the pommel where the speaker is, and then you have the Galactic Empire symbol. So this design came out fantastic. So let's fire it up so you can hear it. So this is a smooth swing on this. Just one of the, I think, 15 fonts on this one that I have. You have your blaster. Lock up, you have to hold down the button, make it clash. Force effect is a little tough. You have to hold down the button and cause a swing. So So they're all a little different. Some are short, some are a little bit longer. To change the blade colors, hold down the button and twist of the wrist. You can see it switched colors. You have all the different colors. You can switch through. And remember your last color that you were on. Hold down the button to turn it off. Now to switch to the other font, you're just going to hold down the button. Selection. So you get into the menu sound. Then you got to do the same thing, just like your color profile. Young Ray. Switch through. Lord Vader. Yeah. You can go all the way around. This is General Kenobi. Only a Sith deal. Cyber assassin. Frozen winds. So we're back to the first sound font. So pretty fast and easy to switch through all the sound fonts. Just hold down the button to lock it in. And you're back on that first font. One of my new favorite fonts. This is actually an old one. If you're not familiar with Pitch Black, this came out a couple years back, but he redid the font. That's Lord Blacko redid the font in a Smoothswing, so it's always one of my favorites back in the day, and I'm super happy that he made it, so of course I had to throw it on this one. Also with the Crystal Focus 10 board, you have the music backtracks and everything too that you can play. So this is the custom commission. Really don't have a name for it. If you actually think of a name, throw it down in the comments, but I'll leave that up to the customer to name his own saber. It's kind of special and unique for each person, and it's a custom one-off, so it's definitely the only one in the world. So you can figure out what he would like to name it. But as always, take care and God bless.